Congratulations.
And the number one new Exxon slogan, hey, you try drinking three or four six-packs and then steering a huge oil tanker. I ain't smoking nothing. Seemed like there was something else we needed to talk about, and I can't recall for the life of me what it was. But let's just get the lovely Connie out here anyway, shall we? Do we have a big, thick, magic marker kind of pen? I have to underline my notes. I see. Forgotten to underline my notes.
Ah.
This would be a rare behind-the-scenes glimpse into the workings of television and show business.
So you underlined what, the most important points?
The salient parts of the question.
I see.
Thank you very much, honey.
Okay.
No, that's not the one I wanted. Could I? This'll do. Oh, boy, wouldn't that have been a terrible mistake? Paul, how about a little underlining music? Okay, fine. There we go. Here we go. All right, Paul. After gracing NBC News and Our Lives for the last 6 years, this is sad. She's been here 6 years, Paul, and now she's leaving. Our first guest is moving up the street, and starting in May, she will become the anchor of West 57th Street on another network, CBS. Please say hello to our very good friend, Connie Chung. Connie, come on out here. Hi, Connie, how are you? I didn't even underline that part. What do we have here? A little gift?
It's your birthday next week.
Oh.
And I brought a little something for you.
A little birthday gift?
Yeah.
Shall I open it now or open
sure.
it later?
No.
All right. We have a little something for you as well because you're departing. Well, as I'm opening this, why don't you tell people how it is you came to leave and why you're leaving and how much money you're getting?
Well, David, I'm sure I'm making less than you are.
Well,
you know?
I would hope so.
You promised. No, seriously.
Only
you know?
As it should be. Well,
no, I mean, I'm sure during contract
time. Oh, these are lovely. These are shoe trees.
Shoe trees.
Shoe trees. Connie and I, a couple of weeks ago, spent the day together, and she went shopping for shoe trees for her husband, Murray, because he has problem... Maury. He has problem feet.
No, he doesn't have problem feet.
He doesn't have problem feet, but
no,
these are...
to keep your shoes...
Wow, look at that.
...stiff and the shape... proper.
Okay, great. Thank you. It's very nice. And we have a little going away gift for you as
you
well.
Yeah.
I hope you enjoy this. We're going to miss you.
Oh,
I think you were a real asset to the operation here.
Oh,
and I think NBC will rue the day they let you slip through their fingers.
Thank you, David.
All right, here we have, this is the Joan Collins fragrance. This is, it's called Spectacular. What? It's spectacular. It's available at your neighborhood True Value hardware stores. This is actually it, and this cost us like, what do you think this went for?
Oh, this is a fortune.
I know.
A small fortune.
Like $800 for this.
You're kidding.
Yeah. Yeah. Who would have thought paint thinner would be running that high? Oh, God, look at this. Well, what is this, the handy applicator? You just pour off a couple of quarts and go gargling.
Let's see.
Mmm.
That's pretty good.
Huh? I don't know, but I enjoyed it. Let's do that again, where we kind of...
Hmm. It's nice. Thank you.
Nice.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So why are you leaving? Tell us about that. Is it an amicable parting?
Sure, absolutely.
Yeah?
Yeah. I mean, everyone was really nice here, and I didn't want to leave.
You didn't get fired or anything, did
you? No.
I didn't think so.
No, it was great. Everyone was really nice, and I don't know. They're just, you know, what happens during a contract time.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you do.
No, I don't.
No, I know. No, I was gonna say with you. You know, you're probably saying, roll up that Brinks truck. You know, just back it up
right here, and let
me have another one.
No.
You know.
No, but you saw this as a better opportunity for you.
Well, no, I was just excited about working with some of the people. The broadcast group, President Howard Stringer, have you ever met him?
Howard Stringer, this name means nothing to me.
Okay. He'd been nurturing this over
CBS?
The years. Yeah.
Yeah.
And David Burke, the president of
Again, these are guys I don't hang around with.
Okay. Andy Lack, the producer of the program. We spent a lot of time.
Again, I don't know Andy Lack.
Okay.
But now you're going to be on West 57th Street. Tell me about that. How will the show be different now?
Well, I can't say. I mean, we've talked about it, and I'd love to sort of tell you exactly what it's going to be like, but I don't know and I can't. So I just have to get there, and I'll be there in a couple of weeks.
But that will be your show.
Yeah.
So all of the other West 57th Street kids are gone?
No. I just don't know. I think I'll just go and we'll talk about it. Mm-hmm. And we'll, you know.
And will you also be anchoring, co-anchoring with Dan?
No.
Yeah. No. Have you met Dan?
Oh, I know him from years ago.
Yeah.
I used to work at CBS in the early 70s, you know, as a correspondent out of the Washington Bureau, and he was working there at the same time.
Yeah.
And, you know, he was the White House correspondent, so I knew him then.
Yeah. And what about the 60 Minutes thing? Are you going to be on 60 Minutes? I guess
no,
you can't because you're on West 57th Street.
You got it.
Yeah.
And
so NBC has nobody left.
No, that's not true.
What it is, Chris Wallace is gone.
Yeah.
You're gone. Tom Brokaw only comes in like late in the afternoon.
No. It's not true.
No, but haven't they just lost a passel of folks?
No, because none of us are
indispensable. Jane Pauley quit this morning.
No,
Jane Pauley quit today.
No, she didn't. None of us are indispensable. You know, I mean, everything's great at NBC, really. It's not a... What?
We have to take a commercial break here. We'll be right back. Due to circumstances beyond our control, the rest of the show will be done with bubbles. I don't have a switch to turn off the machine. I'm sorry, I can't turn it off.
We lost the switch.
You lost the switch. Do you suppose anyone could turn it off?
We'll turn it off.
Okay, great. Should phone Con Ed, have him pull a plug. Because we really don't need, as lovely as the bubbles are, we don't... Watch yourself, Bob.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
A lot of
words. Oh, God. Now, we have a little videotape, and I found this to be amazingly interesting. I've never seen anything like this before as long as I've been alive and watching television, which is really the only reason to be alive, isn't it? I guess this is you now saying goodbye to your NBC staff members, co-workers, friends, peers.
There's nothing ever been on.
All right.
I don't remember.
This will be a surprise for you then. This is, all right, just roll it and then we'll discuss it. And then I think we have it in slow motion. This is Connie Chung saying goodbye to her colleagues and co-workers at NBC News. Hal, roll the videotape.
Also coming up here tonight on NBC Nightly News, an important test firing of a crucial new American missile today.
That was you.
Oh, my God.
You're on the nightly news saying goodbye. Let's see it again. Hal, may we see that again, please?
Oh, my God.
Did you realize they were broadcasting?
Well, yes. I mean...
There's Connie. She comes in. Say, who's the guy you're talking to there?
That's Gene Farinet.
Uh-huh.
And then...
There you are. There she is, Connie, saying goodbye.
That's why I stooped down, because that's Mark Kuznets that I'm saying goodbye to.
Yeah.
And I thought that maybe you wouldn't be able to see me if I were, you know.
Well, guess again, Connie. and at some point...
Oh, my God. I owe Tom Brokaw an apology.
We're waiting for you to go, hey, Tom, adios!
I really owe Tom an apology,
That was very cute.
Oh, God.
Tell me about the big party for your husband. His birthday party, the big surprise party.
Oh, well, that
Connie
was...
is married to Murray...
Maury Povich,
who is the host of...
Current Affair.
That's right.
And he couldn't be here, otherwise he would have come. But he's in L.A. You know, he's going to do the Arsenio Hall show tomorrow.
Oh, good for him. Good for both of them.
He turned 50.
Uh-huh.
And so I decided, you know, that the most awful thing I could do for him would be to give him a surprise birthday
party. He hates surprises?
Well, anybody does.
Yeah.
You know, surprise birthday parties are really dumb, right? So how could I make him embarrassed and humiliate him? Give him a surprise birthday party. And so that's what we did. He thought he was just coming up to have some dinner with his parents and daughters, you know, Susan and Amy.
I bet Susan. I don't know that
you've
I met
never
Amy.
Met him?
No.
Okay. Susan and Amy and his brother and his sister.
Mm-hmm.
And as it turned out, we invited all his closest friends over the years, including your producer, Robert Morton.
Did you organize the whole thing?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How many people were in attendance?
Oh, I don't know, maybe about 50, 60, something like that.
Wow.
They're just old, old friends, you know, and they all just came creeping out of every little doorway. And
I
you
think
know,
that's the right word, too, yeah. Knowing Murray.
But David, I've invited you to parties before, and
you've
you won't come.
You've never invited me to one damn party.
What? Yes, one.
Oh, no,
and you
I wouldn't.
Wouldn't come.
No, not that thing.
No, you wouldn't come.
Well, that was not going to be any fun anyway.
You don't think so?
It was telling people it was going to be me and you and probably Murray and Tom. Tom Brokaw and his wife.
Uh-huh.
And
a few other people.
Like, who were the other people?
I can't remember.
Henry Kissinger or something like that?
No, but you know, but Robert was there. Robert Morton was there. You call him Morty.
Well, everyone calls him Morty.
How come we call him Robert?
Oh, it makes no difference.
All right. I'm sorry, Dave.
Connie, when will we see your smiling face over there at CBS? When will be the first telecast?
2 weeks. Probably the Sunday news. Yeah. I start April 11th. Yeah. That's a Tuesday.
And how soon can we look for Dan Rather to start sweating?
No.
We gotta go. Nice to see you. Thank you for everything.